One of the things that you made very clear to me, and I think it's a spot on insight and was part of what went into you building Inverse, was the mainstreaming of geek culture, that geeks are now taking over the world in a lot of ways. You know, it used to be that it was weird, there maybe wasn't a lot of money in it, and then when I was growing up, there were things like Yu-Gi-Oh! And Pokemon, there was a lot of money in that, but it still wasn't like today. Now you have an explosion of video games, you have nerds and people who ordinarily would be at the bottom of the social hierarchy now being at the top with Silicon Valley. I mean, normally engineers, they weren't the wealthiest ones. The wealthiest ones were the Mad Men people, the people who were really good at socializing and really good looking and often weren't quite as smart. And now you have a world that really rewards intelligence and conscientiousness, and a lot of the nerds are sort of on top. And then you have CEOs like Elon Musk who tap into that, who love that geek culture. What's going on behind that? What was the insight that you had before starting Inverse?
Well, I think, you know, the geeks won, basically. You know, the geeks took over, and, you know, I love it. You know, before I was a sports fan, I was a geek. I think I've always been a geek, still today. But, I grew up reading comic books and obscure sci-fi novels and, you know, just geeking out on this stuff. And I think I became kind of more of a big sports fan, you know, as I, you know, kind of got into like middle school and high school, like a lot of kids do. But it's, you know, part of it was like to be less of a geek and to be, you know, more like, you know, conventionally cool. And, you know, but back when I was doing that, it was, you know, it was not very cool to be a geek. And then, you know, what we've seen, I think, over the last, you know, 15, 20 years is, you know, all of a sudden all these kind of, you know, fringe cultural, you know, kind of ideas and franchises and things like that, all the, you know, kind of, you know, things like computer science and, you know, technology have all kind of, you know, emerged at the forefront. And so when I started Inverse, which was a little over 5 years ago, yeah, that was kind of the central thesis, is that geek culture has become mainstream, and that's, it's not just, you know, kind of the entertainment side of the culture, but it's, you know, the, you know, kind of the science, the technology, you know, kind of aspects of being a geek are also mainstream. And we decided we were going to cover that in a more mainstream way, you know, the same way that, you know, a Bleacher Report would cover sports. And I think, you know, a great example, you know, you mentioned Elon, you know, love him or hate him, you know, some people, you know, are, you know, idolize everything he has to say. Some people, you know, are, you know, roll their eyes anytime he, you know, spouts off on Twitter about, you know, something. But, you know, he's one of the biggest celebrities in the world now. And he's got, you know, kind of a devoted following, and he's doing, of course, really amazing things at SpaceX and Tesla, etc. But he's also, you know, he's just so central in the culture in a way that I think if you were to, you know, kind of, you know, turn the clock back, you know, 5 years and say like, hey, you know, Elon's going to be, you know, this massive figure that, you know, has millions upon millions of followers on Twitter and is going to be, you know, it going to be driving the culture in such a way, you would not expect it. And, you know, we, like, you know, when we started Inverse, you know, he was one of the big people that we decided we were going to cover in a very deep way. Mm-hmm. And I see a lot of parallels between, you know, kind of his personality and kind of the reaction we would get around him and the engagement to, you know, kind of some of the biggest athletes that we would cover at Bleacher Report. And I think especially, you know, the big parallel is around Kobe, you know, RIP, when, you know, in kind of the heyday of Bleacher Report, you know, before the Turner deal. You know, Kobe was you know, kind of definitely, you know, he's still in his prime, he's still in the NBA, and you know, he was just the one athlete that whenever we wrote about him, whenever there was some big story around him, it just got the most engagement on both sides. A ton of people who love him, a ton of people who hate him, but everyone kind of, you know, respects him and, you know, is interested in what he's doing. And, you know, I think Elon is in a similar place now. And that's definitely, you know, kind of, it's a similar pattern anytime we cover him at Inverse. You know, there's just always interest, massive interest on both sides, you know, a legion of followers, a lot of people who are, you know, not the biggest fans of him, but still care about what he's doing. And that's just fascinating to me that we're in this place where, you know, this guy who in probably an earlier era would just be a fringe figure, you know, aerospace and, you know, kind of, you know, tech entrepreneur, but now he's one of the most followed people in the world. That's fascinating to me.